let's start. I understand sometimes people feel lazier after lunch, but let's start. We only have about 3 hours, and we'll try to cover some interesting, inspiring information for you. So best thing is, stop chasing extreme perfection. The next productivity tip is, stop chasing extreme perfection. In today's world, especially in business, everyone is chasing perfection. Now there are scenarios like we talked about 99.9% where we want to improve it. There are scenarios where constant improvement is necessary, but in most areas, being an extreme perfectionist is actually far more harmful than useful. She looks pretty, right? Does she or does she not? You do agree that she does. Yeah. But in reality, there's a lot of change. So I'm not sure, you can't actually see this because it's not very clear, but if you actually go into the picture properly, because I think because of the project, you're not able to see it. But there are a lot of blemishes on her face, and this is when she is making wearing makeup. So my point here is, she's wearing makeup right now. That is, so how did she get from this to there? Here to here?
Photoshop, lighting, tan.
Everything, right? Lighting, Photoshop, tan, all these things. Got her from here to here. And even right now, it's not her real self because makeup and all. So, the thing is, first of all, extreme perfection is largely an illusion. Perfection or extreme perfection is largely an illusion created to make you think that somebody has to perfect, but in reality there are a lot of things that are happening behind the scenes. Most people ruin their health and waste their money trying to chase away something that is mostly fake. Many of these are scams. Before, after visiting, does anybody know Dr. Batra? Anybody heard of Dr. Batra?
Yes. Many holdings, yes.
Huh?
Many advertisements and holdings.
Yeah, you see his holdings. But anyways, many of these are, they say that, so does anybody know who this football player is?
Yeah.
Anyway, many of these are scams basically. So true perfection is 100% perfection, is not only unattainable. When something seems it is perfect, it is often an illusion. Extreme perfectionism can also create problems in workplace. If you are an excessively demanding person, you are likely to have many confrontations with people, which is only going to make them lose respect for you. Even if the project succeeds, people will only remember how you made them feel rather than how much you paid them. Now again, I'll clarify on where perfectionism is important. You may expect everyone to have the same standard as you, however, everybody's motivation is different. First of all, if somebody is talented and skilled, they can achieve far more than the perfectionist. If they are talented and skilled, they can actually achieve far more than the perfectionist if they are, as long as they are putting in the right action. That doesn't make them lazy, that makes them more efficient. So there are instances where this person underperforms compared to this person. There are many instances of people who are actually spending their time partying and all that. They actually perform better compared to somebody who is spending 20 hours at work. Do you agree? There are some instances of that also. Quite a few instances. Why? Now, I'll tell you why in most cases it's not perfectionism should be avoided. So trying to be perfect delays things unnecessarily. Now let's assume you making a rocket launching into space. Now here you have to be as close as perfect to possible. You cannot say no, I'll only work with 80-20. You cannot say I'll only focus on, everybody heard the 80-20 rule, right? Everybody heard the 80-20 rule? 20% of your efforts get you 80% of the result. In some areas you can't apply the 80-20 rule. So you can't say that okay, I'll only launch the rocket 80%. Right? or if you're doing a surgery, you can't apply this. So you should, and you can, and you should pursue extreme perfection areas where the consequence of going wrong is disastrous. That's okay. So 99 to 99.9% you need to go close to perfect, no issues. Many areas, maybe like we talked about regulatory compliances, one needs to go close to perfect because the consequence of going wrong even slightly is disastrous. For the cat here, the consequence of going wrong is disastrous. If he jumps, he'll die. So he should avoid this risk. Trying to be perfect delays things. So in most cases, trying to be perfect will only lead to losses. So, like I said, I'm not saying one should not improve themselves or their product. I'm just saying is, for the vast majority of things, there comes a point where things, where the improvement made does not justify the result. The improvement made does not justify the end result. The returns are so diminishing that the improvement made does not justify it. Now, like I said, there are some areas where you cannot compromise on it. But in most things that you do on a daily life, for example, answering every email immediately or taking every call. Now, except if the call is from your boss or except if the call is from your client, is the consequence of going wrong disastrous? Is it? I'm asking you.
Yeah.
No. No, right? Except if the call comes from your boss, or if the call comes from your client, or the call comes for some people, if it's an angry husband or a wife. Apart from all these cases, is the consequence of immediately picking up every call or immediately answering every email, is the consequence of that disastrous? No. In fact, it only distracts you. So don't try to be an extreme perfectionist. So I'm just giving you a phone example, but many times in work also, there are many areas where you don't need to be perfectionist, and there are many areas where you need a little bit of perfection. So the idea is to identify and focus on the areas. We talked about the three KPI areas, right? We talked about in the previous session that there are three or four areas that directly relate with KPI. Those are the only areas that maybe you should focus on. And even on those areas, you have to figure out what area can I absolutely not compromise on in terms of my perfection or perfectionism. All the other areas, if you try to be perfect in those, you want to delay yourself. It's going to be very fast. And so if you want to achieve 1000 crores in 1000 days, can we be perfect in everything? Can we try to be perfect in everything? My question is that. No, we cannot be. How can you, if you're trying to do 1000 crores in 1000 days, can you be perfect in every area of your business? Can you afford to be perfect? Because when you're trying to be perfect, some areas, yes, are very important to the business. But some areas, if you're trying to be perfect, they're just going to waste your time. They are just going to waste your time. Right? So, I'll give you an example. There are many people, many times in movies also, they're trying to create the perfect movie. They're trying to create perfect, and they take so long to be perfect, that even when the movie comes out or when the product comes out, it flops. Even though they are trying to be perfect. Instead, there are some others who are not trying to be perfect, but they create a great product. But again, we have to be clear on what area you can compromise on and what area you cannot compromise on. Perfectionism without knowledge makes things worse sometimes. He's trying to be perfect, but he doesn't have the knowledge. Sometimes perfectionism actually makes things worse. It actually makes things worse. Contrary to popular belief, perfectionism doesn't always improve the final product. Sometimes it makes it worse. Sometimes it actually makes it worse. A singer that tries to be perfect and practices 18 hours a day, that singer will not deliver a beautiful song. That singer will lose his voice. A runner that over-prepares, does not give himself rest, does not pay attention to injuries, or trying to be perfect, no pain, no gain, they'll just collapse on the day of the race. They'll collapse on the day of the race. Being a perfectionist can kill you. It can kill you. Because, like we talked about, there are many things through stress and all, you know, there are many things that you are facing today that are quite life-threatening. Many of the diseases that we tend to get, it's a result of the stress. Now, sometimes stress is important, many times, but stress should only be required for things that actually give a result. Sometimes you don't actually need to accumulate that much stress, right? So, while striving for perfectionism is a good idea, because it emphasizes the importance of extreme excellence. When you take the idea to an extreme in the wrong areas, it does much more harm than good. So, how can you ditch perfectionism in areas of your life except the ones which where the returns or the cost of going wrong justify the same? Let's do a quick activity. How can you ditch perfectionism or the idea that you have to be completely perfect in areas of your life except the ones where the returns or the cost of going wrong justify the same? Did everybody get it? Any doubts regarding the activity, what this is about? What I am saying is, I am not talking about the place where you have to raise your standard from 99.99%. That is important. The cost of going wrong is disastrous. I am not talking about the areas where constant improvement will help you achieve 1000 crores faster. But I am talking about those areas where trying to be perfect is actually slowing you down. So write down those areas. Take 5 minutes quickly, write it down. What are those areas in your life where trying to be perfect is actually doing more harm than good? That's what I'm trying to know.
You can come.